cogs turned up as they often do. You gotta stay with it, you gotta stay with it. When the world pulls a fast switcheroo, you gotta stay with it, you gotta stay with it. Stay with the truth, yeah. Stay with the truth, yeah. Stay with the truth, and the truth will stay with you. Stay with it, you gotta stay with it. Stay with it, you gotta stay with it. Stay with it, you gotta stay with it, and the truth will stay with you. All through the day, just remind yourself, you gotta stay with it, you gotta stay with it. The climb is steep to avoid a fall, you gotta stay with it, you gotta stay with it. Stay with the truth, yeah. Stay with the truth, yeah. Stay with the truth, and the truth will stay with you.
This video continues the North Shore Satsang, where we focus on absolutes, which is the key to your salvation, to your freedom from suffering. And it's not easy. For some reason, I've always had the capacity to focus on absolutes. And you don't often get this opportunity. Very difficult to find any voice in this world that focuses on absolutes. Very difficult. But that's what is necessary. So that's what we're doing here. Satsang is simply sitting and listening to truth, which is really listening to absolutes. And we're not used to doing this. It takes practice. That's why it's not easy. It doesn't come that easy for us, because we're habituated to focusing on relativeness, plausibility, and relative situations. Well, things are not as bad now as they could be. They're not as bad now as they used to be. Things are going to be better in the future than they are now. That's relative thinking. Relativistic thinking. It's not absolute thinking. It's not absolutes. What we are is spirit. Spirit is an absolute. It's an extension of the mind of God. It's an idea in the mind of God extended, not leaving the mind of God in this extension. It remains in the mind of God. Spirit is endless, endless being. It's perfect, it's flawless. It can never be corrupted, changed, distorted, tarnished. It's eternal from the very beginning. That's why it's an absolute. What we are is an absolute. Reality is an absolute. There's no exceptions to what reality is. That's why it's an absolute. So absolutes really mean no exception whatsoever. Zero. This world that we think we're experiencing is an attempt to forget what we are, to forget absolutes, forget the absolute nature of reality. It's an attempt on the part of spirit to forget what it is. Forget what is, because spirit wants to be prime creator. It has this crazy whim to see if it can be prime creator, and so of course it has to forget what it is. These are the basic teachings, because if it knows what it is, it knows it's created. It knows that it's an extension in the mind of God. It's not prime creator, so it's trying to forget reality, the nature of reality. It's trying to completely forget it. So it goes into this deep sleep of forgetfulness, and it has this dream of plausibility, this hypothetical scenario we call existence. And of course, all of this existence is also denying its authorship, denying where it came from. Where did it come from? From spirit. From the idea that spirit had of being prime creator. The mind then presents this idea to spirit. So technically it's coming from mind, but mind is a servant of spirit, so you cannot blame the servant for the orders that are given to the servant. So it's coming from spirit. And yet this existence does not recognize this at all, because that's its purpose, is to not recognize authorship, not recognize origin, not recognize that it's an extension of spirit. So spirit can look at this and say, well, you see, this whole entire existence does not recognize where it came from, so therefore it should be possible for spirit to not recognize where it came from. It reinforces the notion of forgetfulness to spirit. Spirit looks at all of existence and realizes that none of existence recognizes spirit as the author of all of this. And then that, for spirit, that brings a sense of tremendous forgetfulness and a feeling that, therefore, it's possible for spirit not to recognize where it came from. Now, the absolute means that effects are in alignment with ideas from the very beginning and always remain in alignment, no exception. It's an absolute statement. So this world is in alignment from the very beginning with the purpose, with the idea of forgetting, providing a reinforcement, providing a picture of forgetfulness, a mirror of forgetfulness. It's like spirit is looking into this mirror, and this world is the mirror that reflects back this sense of denial of authorship. That's its purpose, and it was this way from the very beginning and will always be this way. So it's futile, and there's another absolute, futility, meaning completely futile, impossible to accomplish, another absolute statement, for this mirror to reflect authorship back to spirit, for spirit to look in the mirror of existence and know exactly what it is and be fully reminded, perfectly reminded that spirit itself was authored by the Prime Creator. It never happened. All that happens is like taking a mirror and rotating it, like changing this world, trying to change the world is like trying to rotate a mirror. You know, let's say your spirit's looking in this mirror and it says, gee, I'm not getting any reflection back of what I am, of truth, of reality. I'm not remembering what I am. And so mind says, oh, okay, not a problem. Here, let's rotate the mirror, 90 degrees. Now look, what do you see? Spirit says, well, I see this the same. And then so mind says, okay, let's rotate it another 90 degrees. And what do you see now? Spirit says, well, it's still the same, really. And mind says, okay, let's rotate it 3.5 degrees. What do you see now? And now let's tilt it a little bit, you know. Tilt and rotate a little bit. Tilt and rotate. Oh, still don't like it? No. Still not helping you remember what you are? No. Okay, let's tilt and rotate a little more. This direction, that direction. That's all that's happening. The mirror is the same. The reflection is the same. Just tilting and rotating doesn't change the fundamental situation at all. So it's not right to focus on the world and the changes that are taking place and that changes that may happen in the future, changes that took place in the past. That's all a waste of time. Because the basic reflection has always been the same and will always be the same here. It's futile to expect the world to provide the reflection of remembrance. Because in order for that to happen, effects have to separate from cause, separate from idea, which is exactly what spirit wants, because it's an idea in the mind of God. And in order to be prime creator, spirit wants to separate from God, from the idea that the spirit is an extension of. So the whole purpose of existence is to believe that effects can separate from cause. So as we try to change the world, we're only reinforcing this delusion. We're trying to change the reflection this world is giving us. We're basically, what we're saying is that we believe that effects can be separated from cause and made to reflect something other than the purpose that gave rise to it. It's not possible, it's impossible. So as we try and struggle with existence and to change existence, we're literally reinforcing delusion. Even if that change is dressed up in the highest type of idealism, still exactly the same. We're reinforcing delusion. the way to get a true reflection of what we are is to choose a different idea. And then the extension of that idea as effects will provide that a true reflection. And that idea is the idea of not trying to be prime creator. That's the basic teachings here. Basic teachings of salvation. All you need is the basic teachings. We're not trying to do anything with existence. Writing it off, realizing it will never provide the reflection of remembrance. And for sure, the overwhelming majority of activity that is taking place here is an attempt to change existence. That is the sickness that the world suffers from, the delusion. Well-meant intentions, but what they say, the road to hell is paved with good intentions. Definitely true. It's more like to say the road to delay is paved by good intentions. All you have to do is ask yourself, how do you feel right now? Is right now, are you experiencing a true reflection of remembrance of what you are? As you look about, do you feel perfect? Do you feel everything is perfect, reflecting perfectly what you are? That you're invulnerable, eternal, completely untouched by any change or distortions or aging or death or sickness? Are you feel, do you feel completely, blissfully peaceful without any concern that it could ever change or any be otherwise? And if the answer is no, as it most certainly has to be no, as we are still experiencing this world in the way we are, then it's not a reflection is not a true reflection of what you are. It's not helping you remember. It's not a remembrance right now. It's not adequate. We can all agree upon that. That's a starting point. Now, from there, we will say, since it's not adequate right now, the fact is it can't possibly ever be adequate then, because effects don't change from the purpose that they are an extension of. So it means if it's not adequate now, it means it never has been adequate and never will be adequate. In other words, it is what it is. Right now, it's exactly the same purpose as it always has been, always will be. So all we need is to look at right now. We don't need to look at history or the future. We don't need to look at history and say, oh, you know, it was really terrible back then and I had all these problems. But we're overlooking right now because by looking at the past, we're basically saying, well, right now is different. But what we're saying is, it's impossible for effects to share a different purpose in time and space from the origin of those effects. It's not possible. It's not possible then for the effects to change purpose. Totally impossible. That's an absolute. If that were possible, then that would be possible for spirit to be prime creator. Because spirit could say, well, I'm going to change from being prime created to being prime creator. The spirit is an effect of the extension of the idea of God. And if spirit says, well, no, effects can change purpose, then spirit says, I can change the purpose and be prime creator. So, exactly the same situation. Spirit saying, no, we can change the effects of this world to give proper reflection of remembrance. And that seems to be a very spiritual goal, right? But actually, it's the opposite. The goal of trying to change the world so it gives an accurate reflection of what we are, that's actually the goal of spirit trying to be prime creator. Because if this were possible, then spirit could change its purpose to be prime creator. That's exactly what it's trying to do. So it disguises this. And we think we're trying to make the world a better place to reflect better what we are. But that's not what's taking place at all. All the righteous activity in the world, all the spiritual activity to try and make this world a better reflection of what we are, that's literally the attempt for spirit to be prime creator. The real teaching of salvation is to say that this world can never reflect what we are. It can never change its purpose from giving a reflection of forgetfulness to giving a reflection of remembrance. That's impossible. And we can realize the reflection right now is not reminding us of what we are. Remember, what we are is, without exception, completely flawless. So are we getting a completely flawless, eternal, endless, effortless reflection of what we are right now? Or is that what we're experiencing? And if any, all it takes is the slightest bit of honesty to realize this is not so. The weather may not be perfect for us right now. And if it's perfect, it's certainly to change. And we realize that it changes. And we also realize it didn't used to always be this way. If we're experiencing a perfect day, well, was yesterday like this? The day before? No. So right now, we're aware that everything is going to change about our situation. There's no stability. We're aware of that right now. We're aware that the flowers that are blooming right now won't be blooming, you know, in a couple months' time. We're aware that the summer, the season we're experiencing is going to change. We're aware that we have to eat another meal coming up soon because hunger is going to strike us. We might be feeling hungry right now. None of that reminds us of what we are. It's not a perfect remembrance. Remembrance has to be perfect, has to be flawless, has to be without exception. Otherwise, it's not a remembrance of what we are at all. What we are is an absolute. Reality is an absolute. There are no exceptions to the way that reality works. Ideas cannot leave their source. Effects cannot leave ideas. At all. It's impossible. No exceptions. And we can feel the full reflection of existence right now. Don't have to wait for tomorrow to look at this. We can look at it right now because we can be perfectly certain that right now we're not getting a true reflection of what we are. And therefore the purpose of existence must be forgetfulness of what we are. Even though it's trying to disguise this as a path of remembrance, an evolution of consciousness. That's a disguise for the purpose of existence. Don't fall for that. That's my whole purpose here. Purpose of truth is to remind you not to fall for that. That is the disguise, the front, the facade, that we're on some evolutionary path, a path going back home. It's not true. That's all just cycling. You'll find that as you think you're taking this path, you will think you're getting close to remembering what you are. And as you get right on the brink of it, you'll suddenly slip back and start forgetting again. And then you realize you're just going to go through another cycle of forgetfulness that seems to be bringing back to a seems remembrance, which then cycles back to forgetfulness endlessly. That's the game of existence. And eventually, as you get tired of this, you get frustrated, you say, wait a minute. Something's wrong with this whole situation. Because we think we're making progress. But again, that's literally reinforcing the delusion and the forgetfulness of what we are by thinking that effects can change purpose midstream. Effects can change the purpose of what they serve. Not true. So if the effects are not giving us a perfect remembrance of what we are right now, that means the effects are serving the purpose of forgetfulness and will always serve that purpose. And so it's completely futile to wait in the future for the effects to remind you of what you are. It's not going to happen. It will never happen. So the only way out is to choose a new idea, and the effects will serve that idea perfectly well. They won't change stream. They won't change course. We don't trust choosing a new idea. Why? Because we're under the delusion that effects can change the purpose of what they serve, the purpose they're serving. So we think even if we choose a new idea of remembrance, of not trying to forget what we are, of not trying to be prime creator, that the effects may be blissful and perfect remembrance for a while, but then somehow they're going to change and suddenly we'll be plunged into forgetfulness. And so we don't trust it. We'd rather just stay with this oscillation, this delusional oscillation this mirage of success that we're familiar with. We don't want to leave the familiar for something different if that something different is only going to become unstable again. In other words, we're already comfortable, used to, habituated to instability. So we don't want to feel stability only to have the rug pulled out from underneath us. You know, we don't want that. So we hesitate. So it's very important to recognize that the belief that effects can change the purpose of what they serve is delusional. It's false. The effects of existence will always serve the purpose of forgetting what we are. They've never changed at all. And once we see that, then we'll have trust that the effects of a new idea, the idea of not forgetting what we are, those effects won't change from serving that purpose either. And the remembrance of what we are will be stable, will not suddenly change. It's not possible. It's impossible that that could happen. As long as we believe that it is possible for effects to change the purpose that they serve, we will not choose a new idea. We won't trust it. So we are locked into the stalemate. And the purpose I'm here to serve is to break that stalemate, break that logjam. It's like a vast logjam. You've seen when they used to float, they still probably do float logs down rivers. Massive number of logs, and you'd have these people walking on all these logs, pushing them, removing the log jam. Tricky job, you know, on these spinning logs in a river. They'd push this log here, push this log there, and eventually they remove the log jam. The logs are jammed up. So we're in a log jam. We're in a stalemate. The more we want to believe that existence can reflect what we truly are, the more we will not trust choosing a new idea. That is the terrible stalemate. So really, you have those in the world who are seem to be most spiritual, who are pressing for changes in the world and thinking that this world can be made a wonderful place. They're the ones who literally disbelieve, don't trust choosing a new idea the most, because they've invested in changing the world the most, meaning they've invested in the belief that effects can change the purpose that they serve. And therefore, they will not trust choosing a new idea. They will insist, we must make this world a better place. That's the only hope we have. Unfortunately, that leads to, as I've said, totalitarianism, fascism, all sorts of extreme regulation and control from bureaucracies, a lack of freedom of expression, of ideas, etc. Sort of know-it-all bureaucracy that will say, look, making this world reflect what we are is the only avenue we have, the only option we have, therefore you must put all your efforts in that direction. And if you're not, you are quote-unquote counter-revolutionary, or you are opposing happiness. You're obstructing salvation. And that's the situation that this world is going in. We've lost contact, for the most part, with the absolute teaching, the true teachings, which talk about absolutes and give no... tell you, look, the more you believe you can change this world, the more deluded you are, and the more you'll feel frightened of what really works. So the remedy is, again, satsang and listening to truth, focusing on absolutes. Don't be worried if you think you're not so spiritual about doing that. Just the opposite. It seems in this world that the most spiritual people are those who are trying to change the world and make it a better place. And the fact is just the opposite. Those are the ones who are most deluded. Because those are the ones who are most distrustful of the real remedy, was to choose a new idea. Choose the idea of not trying to be prime creator, not wanting to be prime creator, which automatically provides an effect which overlays everything that we have made. Gives a perfect reflection of remembrance, like a mirror that gives us perfect remembrance of what we are. And in my other videos, I've gone into that in detail, and will continue to do so. But what I'm want to focus in on this video is this dynamic, this stalemate that we're stuck in. And we want to be recognized as spiritual here in this world. Like, so what happens is, I'm a testimony, direct testimony of what happens. You come into this world wanting to help, wanting to point out the truth. And people say, wow, you're really spiritual. That's great. So you must believe in these teachings, these spiritual teachings. And you must agree with this and this and this. And what they're really saying is, certainly you must agree with the attempt to make this world a better place. Because that's what we believe, that's what spiritual people do, right? And then you start to say, huh, and nobody listens to you. And you think, well, I better at least try to align myself somewhat with these spiritual teachers and teachings in the world of making this world a better place. Otherwise, no one will pay any attention to what I have to say. Nobody has any idea what I'm talking about. So there's an attempt to make some sort of lukewarm alignment with that. But when that happens, then one feels that one's lost the truth. Lost the true reflection of what one is. Has tried to get into a compromised position, which leads to extreme confusion. The truth is that those who know the truth will not be seen as spiritual people in this world at all. Because they're not trying to make the world a better place. One of my teachers, Sri Ananda Maimon, never tried to make the world a better place. Everybody around her thought that's what she was here for. So they said, look, we need to build more hospitals. We need to build more temples. We need to alleviate suffering and poverty and starvation and all these things. And surely that's what you're here for. So why can't you help us do that? Will you please help us do that? And she just, would ignore it. And would say, that's not what I'm here for. And they couldn't understand that. They said, we need to build ashrams. We need to do this and this and that. Let's make the world a better place. Let's find political solutions to these economic problems. Let's give more social justice, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. The whole litany of things that so-called spiritual people are engaged in. All the charities and all that. And she said, no, that's not the answer. That's not why I'm here. And sometimes she would very begrudgingly, if they just couldn't help themselves from insisting on things, she would shrug her shoulders, but she was not interested. There was complete indifference to that, total indifference. And so we tend to think that, wow, it's very cold, very indifferent. Just the opposite. It's showing us the truth. This attitude of high indifference is the overlay. And I've spoken about the overlay in other videos extensively. But there are some teachers that come into this world and their attitude to this world is complete indifference. Total indifference to changing anything. That's the right attitude, because what they're saying is, the more you try to change the world, the more you will distrust choosing a different idea. And choosing a different idea is the only way that you will have a remembrance of what you are. It's the only way. So literally, as you try to change the world, you are blocking your salvation. Now, I'm not saying you need to make the world worse. That also is blocking. Because you're still thinking you can change the purpose here. That's like a petulant overreaction. You don't need to do anything to this world. You need to just let it be what it is. Let it alone. It's a mirror of forgetfulness. What you need to do is look in the mirror of remembrance. It's two mirrors. You simply decide which one to look into. You don't try to change the mirrors. You don't try to rotate and tilt them. Thinking that somehow that the effects can choose which purpose they serve. That is a lie. That's the central lie at the very root of your problem, of our problem here. The central lie that effects can choose the purpose that they serve. That is exactly spirit saying that it can choose the creator that it serves. It can even choose to say, I'm not even serving a creator. I wasn't created at all. I created myself. That's not possible. Can spirit decide what created it? And spirit say, no, the prime creator didn't create me. I was created some other way, or me even, I don't even know what created me. Or I'm free to choose to say that I created myself. Is that possible? To keep it very simple, can spirit say, is it up to spirit to decide what created it? Is that true? And intuitively, we know that's a lie. So the very same principle applies to what spirit is projecting existence. Is it up to effects to choose what purpose gave rise to those effects? Is that really the way reality? And of course we intuitively know, no, that's a lie. Effects are not free agents to decide what purpose they're serving, what purpose gave rise to them. And yet that is what we're trying to do when we're trying to change this world. We're trying to say, well, it may be that the purpose of this world was to forget what we are. And that's what the purpose the effects have served up to now. But we're gonna change the purpose that these effects are serving. We're going to change that. We're going to say, okay, effects, you're going to serve a different purpose here now. Is that possible? Because that's literally what we believe in. Even though it's not spoken of openly in this world, hardly at all. But this is literally our problem, false belief, that somehow we can have the effects that are this existence serve a different purpose, choose to serve a different purpose. You cannot do that. Just like spirit cannot decide to choose to serve a different prime creator, because there's only one prime creator. Not two. So intuitively we know this. So it's futile to try and get this world to give reflection of remembrance. That's not its purpose. The effects will always serve the purpose of forgetfulness. Forgetting what reality is. So trying to do this is just grandstanding. It's just being spiritual posers, you know. It's sure. Many people will look at some, if you want to take that position, like, hey, folks, I can change what the effects are reflecting. I can get the effects of existence to reflect back remembrance. Sure, you might get a big following by doing that, because that's what everyone believes is possible here. And you might go down in history as some spiritual person, but I guarantee you will find yourself reincarnated back here and very, very miserable and frustrated, because it doesn't work. So the goal is not to appear to the world as spiritual. The goal is to remember what you are and then remind others what the real way is. The true way. The only reason I can speak the way I am speaking is because my teacher has reminded me of the true way. Because I had true teachers. That's the only reason I can do this. Intuitively, we all know the truth. But our habituation is so extreme here that it's extremely difficult to speak the truth here if we don't have reminders of it. We don't have some feeling of support and remembrance, and yes, this is the right thing to say. We'll get shaky and wobbly and unstable and uncertain, and we'll fall into compromise positions very easily, because the world is overwhelmingly deluded. And of course the spiritual posing of being able to change effects will appear attractive to us, because we think, oh, the message can be spread more easily this way. I can help out more better if I, you know, get a compromise a little bit. That's what happens. Happens to all of us. Only a few have not done this. So those few serve as role models for the rest of us. That's why I highlight these role models. My teacher, Sri Nandamayama, Jesus Christ. Those are the two primary ones. And Ramana Maharshi, also very supportive. And there are others throughout history, but these are the ones that I have been fortunate enough to be aware of and to pay attention to. And so they reinforce truth here. They make it possible for this type of teaching to point you to where your salvation really can be found. They make it possible, they've made it possible for this to be taking place right now, even though they came at different times in history. Different times, different places, different modes of expression, etc. Still pointing to the exact same dynamic. Effects cannot change the purpose that they serve. They cannot choose a different purpose. Effects cannot choose a different purpose to serve. Again, effects cannot change a different purpose to serve. It's impossible. And we are trying to accomplish the impossible. And we are deluded into thinking that trying to make the world a better place is the way to go about it, when in fact that's the way not to go about it. That is what reinforces delusion, literally. That's what keeps us estranged in a situation of forgetfulness of what we are. Trying to improve, trying to make the world better, is the belief that effects can choose a different purpose to serve. That is it. And that is, again, spirit wanting to choose to not serve the prime creator, so it can be prime creator. That's the entirety of it right there. And again, it doesn't mean we run out and try to make the world a worse place. Not saying that. We're saying to choose a different idea. So we get a reflection of remembrance. So this world is overlaid by a seamless, perfectly pure, unchanging reflection of what we are. Gives no exception. Realizes that everything, all attempts to accomplish the impossible are equally futile. That is what we're saying, is to choose a different idea. We're not saying to go out and make the world a worse place. Not at all. Simply let the world be what it is. It's already a terrible place. Don't need to make it worse. It's already a terrible reflection of forgetfulness. No reason to make it worse. Why would we want to waste time making it worse? It already is what it is. It's not going to change. Making it worse can't be made worse. It's already what it is. Can't be made better either. So neither better nor worse. Rather, choose a different idea. Very simple. In the eyes of existence, this is not what it's looking for. So existence overlooks this option, which is why we need the teachers to remind us. We come into this world, we really end up overlooking the truth severely. It's very humbling. I came into the world, I even forgot almost entirely, but not quite entirely. There's still an intuitive sense, a remembrance of the truth, but this world gives us vastly dark experiencing of confusion and misdirection and delusion and bafflement. As you try to spread the truth, the true option in this world, you run into vast confusion, and people say they have no idea what you're talking about, and they really don't understand at all what you're saying. That's what happens. And yet here we are, thanks to the great teachers that have come. So all thanks to the teachers that have come, and all thanks to the grace of God, which has made it possible to be reminded of what the truth really is. All right, very great. That's it.